With recent innovations in AI for video, we can now build our rough cuts faster with the help of text-based editing tools and silence removers. Let's take a look at how they work. Hey everyone, I'm Kelsey. I'm the creator of Premiere Gal. On my YouTube channel, you'll find tons of tips and tricks to keep up to date with the latest video editing tools. For this video, we will be using Premiere Pro. Let's jump on in. So here inside of my timeline, I have this video clip and you can see that there are gaps in the waveforms. Those are silences that can be removed. But with the help of third-party plugins like Autocut, you can have AI remove those silences for you. So here I have the Autocut plugin installed and we can go to the Autocut AI, and I recommend choosing 4 for aggressiveness. And down below, it'll show you a preview of the silences it's going to remove. And down here where it says delete silences, make sure that this is checked on, and then press cut. And it's so fast. In 3 seconds, it did 36 cuts. Now we can use text-based editing to quickly edit our rough cut. All right, so let's go ahead and let's close the AutoCut panel. And now we can head over to the text panel and you can see that it's already generated a transcript for us. And that's because I have auto transcription turned on. If you go to Premiere Pro Preferences Transcription, it'll bring up a window where you can choose if you want your clips automatically transcribed or not. I have mine turned on, but you can always turn this off here and then press OK. I also want to note that I'm using the Premiere Pro Public Beta, which you also have access to from your Adobe Creative Desktop app. So the transcript that was generated, if I click on any word, it'll take me to that moment inside of my timeline. You can see my playhead is moving. So every word is time-coded to our timeline. If you need to go in and quickly update a misspelling, for example, lavalier here is misspelled, I'm going to double-click, and then I can type in the new spelling. You can also go up to search and search for a particular word, for example, microphone, and this will highlight the words inside of the transcript for you so you can quickly go to that time code and find that sound bite. So now let me show you how to edit with the transcript. So you can see here that I messed up in the beginning. I said these phrases, my YouTube video, my YouTube video, my YouTube video, a few times. And here I said the full sentence. So what I'm going to do is select this text here, and then I can go up here and click extract, or I can press the apostrophe key on my keyboard, which is the shortcut, and it will ripple delete those clips together in the timeline. Of course, you can always use basic commands like command X to cut a section and paste it at a different time code. So the same things that you can do in a document can apply here as well. And just like that, we have the rough cut finished. So now I can go through the Storyblocks plugin and find additional stock footage that I can use as B-roll in the rough cut. So the beauty of using the Storyblocks plugin is you can search their unlimited royalty-free stock footage directly in Premiere Pro. You don't need to go into the web version of Storyblocks. You can do it all from within your video editing software. By default, it's set to all video, but you can also search their huge libraries for backgrounds, templates, all audio, and all images as well. So because I'm talking about my YouTube editing setup in this video, I'm gonna search for Canon because I use a Canon camera. And let's download a few of these clips here. And so I'm going to download the MOV version and it will start to download. Another really useful tip, if you go up here to your avatar and go to download settings, you want to make sure that you're downloading it into your project folder. So I like to make a folder called Storyblocks Downloads inside of my project folder. And that way it'll all be set to that one location and I don't have to worry about media getting offline. You can always change this by clicking on Browse. And you can see after I download all of them, they appear here inside of my project panel. If we go down to the icon view, you can see that they've all been nicely imported here, ready for me to then drop into my timeline. So let's search for a couple more things. And what's really cool is you can download in 4K or HD. And I actually like to edit in HD, so that's why I chose the HD version. But you have that option here to choose 4K. To To set in and out points on your B-roll, you can scrub to the point here in the icon view, press I for an endpoint, and then press O for an out point. So now I'm just taking this highlighted blue section into my timeline. You can also double click on a clip and then choose your in and outs by pressing I for in and O for out, and then drag the video clip into your timeline from the source monitor itself. So I pulled in the clips and here's a little snippet of the rough cut. So my YouTube video essentials are, of course, my lights, my USB microphone, my Canon DSLR, as well as my wide angle lens. And of course, some other essentials are my tripod as well as a gimbal for certain scenarios. So using the Storyblocks plugin in Premiere just speeds up my editing because I don't have to go back and forth between the web browser and my video editing software. So I hope from this video you saw how useful AI can be in removing those pauses as well as helping you edit your rough cut faster using that auto-generated transcript. Of course, you still have to go through and make those creative decisions to decide what parts need to be removed, but AI gets you halfway there. So if you're editing long interviews or video podcasts, try out this workflow and let me know how it goes. If you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below, as well as subscribe to Storyblocks so you can check out more tutorials in this playlist. Also, click the link down below so you can check out the Storyblocks subscription plans. Thanks so much for watching. Bye!